So now we need to code for like if our Dino collide with the evil. So we need to make our game over and we need to display the another screen. Okay, so how we can do this? So it's very simple as that. Let's go to the block. Okay, first we'll check that this is the image sprite one, right? Open the main screen, this one. So go to the block and we need to just search here. We need to just click on the image sprite one like this and see here image sprite one collide with. If image sprite collide with anything, okay, then we need to make our game over. Okay, so or you can do here condition like if that collide with the particular only image. Okay, so or like if, like suppose let's try if, okay, and logic and equal, if that, if image sprite collide, then if that other, like if that other, if image sprite collide with other, and this is the other, and other is what, other is something, this is our evil. Okay, and that evil image is like image sprite 2, like this. If that image sprite 2, just drag and drop it here, okay, zoom it. If it's image sprite 2, then we need to make our game over. So we need to display our another screen. We need to, first of all, we need to hide our main layout, okay, like this, side visible, turn off, okay, false, like this. And we need to just display our game over screen. So select the game over layout, this one, and make it true, like this, okay. But once we do this, we need to disable the timer also, okay. So we need to just use here, what we can do, we can use the procedure, okay. So what the procedure, procedure is something like you can call the code, okay, using the bulk, like clock is set, timer is like, suppose clock false, this procedure name is clock, okay, clock off, or I'm gonna create one more procedure for clock on, because we need to use that for multiple time, okay. So clock interval one should be true, okay, like this, and that is the false, okay, that should be, okay, no, not sorry, interval, that should be enabled, I'm sorry, that should be false, okay, false. And same thing we need to do for the another, like clock 2, that is also will be false, like this. In the clock on procedure, clock on procedure, I'm gonna call the same thing, okay. So like this, copy paste, and but I need to just make it the true, like true, and just copy paste this one also here and just make it also true, the clock 2 also, like this. Now we need to call it, so just click on procedure, you see the clock off, we need to call clock off, okay, like this. And make sure we need to disable both clock in the initial, timer enable, timer enable should be false. Go to the block, and once the game or start, like this play button is here, this one, okay, this is button one. So once our game will start, we need to call it again procedure for the clock on, this one. So our game will start and you know, the our horizontal and our layout will start moving like this. So this is done for now. Now what we need to do here, let's try, like what we need to do here, whenever we click on the another button, like we have just the main screen, we'll come back again here, like let's open the game over screen. Once the game is over, so that screen will display, but we need to click on the replay button, right? And which replay button? Button 2. So once the people click on the button 2, so like game over screen like this, so I'm gonna just do that code and here, okay. So once the people click on the button 2, we need to do the same thing as like, we need to, first of all, we need to enable the timers. So I'm gonna use the procedure to enable timer first of all. Then we need to enable the layout also, like see here, you can see the main screen, make sure that should be enabled, true. And the layout game over screen should be disabled. So make it game over screen, that should be false, like this. Okay, once we start this, okay, but we need to stop that sound once the game is over. So let's first do one thing, player, and you'll see the start that you can do here, like here, but we need to stop it once the collide. So we need to turn it off on here, here, once the collide, image sprite collide. So we need to stop this sound because our game is over, that's why, like this. Okay, now one thing is important here, because we need to use here the, you know, let's go to the main screen here and game overload. See, we need to do one main thing is like, we need to use our, you know, that background should be infinite loop. Okay, so how we can do this? So for that we need to go to the block here, and we need to set the option like horizontal scroll here, and you will see the option of horizontal scroll handler reach right hand. Okay, reach left and reach right hand, this one. Okay, call it here. Once this reach the right hand, so we need to do one thing. We need to set our horizontal, you know, we need to set that should be the again to the left. Okay, so how we'll do that? So it's simple, is like set, and you'll see the horizontal scroll handle scroll left hand. So left hand, this one. So again that will set to the left, and again that can again scroll like this. But here we need to do one more thing here. We need to move our image split also to the front. So how we can do this? So simple is like we need to do for that, like go here, image split one is in here, and see the move like this. And we need to call the x value is maths, go here, and just x value is 10, and the y value you can just select the image split dot y, because there is no changes on the image split. Or you can, this is defined by you, because you have just used the ups and down button, so that will be in the same position like this. Okay, now what you can do here, there's a lot more option. Is like once we can do here, one thing option we can do, we can change the image also. You can see I have added here one.png image. Okay, this is for the night, but if you want to display the day also, so how we can do this? So I'm going to just upload one more file here, click on choose file, 2.png, and this is for the night. I think this is day one and this is day two for the night. So I'm going to use here that night image. Okay, upload this image, go to the blocks, it will take some seconds to upload. Okay, so here I'm going to use the if else condition. Okay, simple, to display to the night or day. Okay, so simply I'm going to just use here the logic if. Okay, if 1.png is equal, so just 1.png, you can how I get that 1.png, simple click on anywhere on the screen and just type here 1.png like this, your image name. Okay, and just drag and drop it here. 1.png is equal to the canvas. Here you can see, here we have canvas dot background image. You can see the background, so let's do here background image, this one. If that is the background image, suppose one, then we need to set that background image to the something else. Simple, as like background image can be the 2, like this, 2.png. okay, else I'm gonna use here, simply use the first one. If there is no first, there will be 2. If there is a only first, then there will be 2. Okay, if they equal to false, then we need to set the 2.png. if this condition is false, it means there is a 2, then we need to set this to 1. Okay, so that will perform the night and day like this in our game. So set that code like this here. This is for button 1, this is for clock like this. You can do a lot more thing in this. Okay, so I'm gonna just check all the things is fine or not here. If there is anything missing, so I'm gonna just add all the things. Okay, so let me just check it once the code. So I'm gonna test this. Let's go to the design. Okay, I'm gonna just make it that layout visible, that layout main screen to the turn off, and let's try how this will work. So this is the overall game that we have completed, the Flying Dino game. So there are a lot more possibilities to add something. Is like we can add here the scores option. So we can add one more timer, and we can increase the score option, and we can use one label, and we can increase that value by timer, and we can display at the end of the game or game over screen. That we can do. So that's the task for you guys, and just complete that task also, and just give me the email me, or just send me the comment, or just comment me that we have completed the task. What I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna just give you that whole code, whole AIF file on my website, thecodingbus.info. okay, so you can download that whole code from that website. So thank you so much for joining this video. If you have any doubt, you can ask me on comment. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.